Kenya's plastic bag ban is aimed at protecting the environment. And while the move has garnered praise, there's also been significant criticism.
Plastic carrier bags is the thing. Any other alternative will not come close to that. The next alternative will be something like if plastic is costing about 20 cents, the other one will be costing about 50 shillings. So who is going to opt for that?
The government and other stakeholders are advocating for alternatives.
We must also promote the use of other natural resources, of which are abundant in Kenya.
The government has organized an exhibition for traders showcasing alternatives to plastic bags.
Environmental sustainability is not cheap, so it has a cost to it. And I think the culture in Kenya today, it's not that of, we are more on cost. And a lot of times when you're bringing something new and something pricey, the guys, they don't embrace it much. Yeah, so what we're doing today, I'm actually surprised guys have come out a lot. I'm hoping that they'll embrace the change.
Despite the outcry, the minister in charge is adamant the ban will go ahead.
From the 28th, you will see that in most of the formal neighborhoods, you will not have access to polythene bags. We also want to make it very clear that on the 29th, you will not walk around Kenya and not see a bag.
Vested parties say the government should have handled the matter differently.
The minister has said that the people should do research at the university to bring down the cost of the alternatives. You don't ban and ask people to do research. You ask people to do research first, and when you have the alternatives as cheap as possible or close to plastics, then you can ban.
But the government is sticking to its guns.
So of course there are those that are opposing, but those that are opposing are in denial.
Many organizations are planning to take full advantage of the ban.
I'm also thinking that there's an opportunity. Like in Kenya, we don't make a lot of fabric or decomposable material. There's little market actually for us like a business. We'd had trouble sourcing for the fabric, for the materials. It's quite hard. It's something that we've not been doing. So that's a business opportunity for manufacturers.
I think that a lot of people will now come and buy our products because now we're seeing that the demand will be high.
Kenya is one of several countries on the continent that have taken similar steps to protect the environment from plastic pollution. Vic Chege, CGTN.